Now for the formal definition of a polynomial reduction. This should feel very similar to the reductions that we considered when we were talking about computability. A language A is polynomially reducible to a language B, and we write this as A less than or equal to B with the subscript P over the less than or equal to sign, if there's a polynomial function F where for every string W, W is in A if and only if F of W is in the language B. The key difference from before is that we have now required that the function be computable in polynomial time, not just that it be computable. We will also say that F is a polynomial time reduction of A to B, or sometimes from A to B. Here's the key implication of there being a polynomial reduction of one language to another. Let's suppose that I want to know whether a string X is in the language A, and suppose also that there exists a polynomial decider, M, for the language B. Then all I need to do is take the machine or program that computes this reduction function, let's call it N, and feed my string X into it, and then feed that output into M. M will tell me if F of X is in B. But, by definition of a reduction, this also tells me whether X is in A, which is exactly what I wanted to know. I just had to change my problem into one encoded by the language B, and then I could use B's decider. By the way, this square bracket notation means 1 if the expression inside is true, and 0 otherwise. Therefore, the composition of M with N is a decider for A, by all the same arguments we used in the context of computability. But is it a polynomial decider?